Hey guys, this is Matt, one of Hydroviv's water nerds. Our email has been overflowing with questions about Chromium 6, so we thought we'd put together a quick video that answers some of the most frequently asked questions. Question number one, is Chromium 6 the same thing as regular Chromium? No. You can think of Chromium as coming in two main chemical flavors. Most of the Chromium that you encounter in your everyday life, like the kind used in stainless steel and dietary supplements, is definitely not toxic. There is no reason to be getting rid of your stainless steel cookware. Chromium 6, or hexavalent chromium, on the other hand, is a completely different animal. It's discharged by a number of polluting industries, and it is extremely toxic. Question number two, is the recent news coverage the result of a spike in Chromium 6 levels? It's not. The recent uptick in media coverage is shining a light on something that environmental scientists have known about for a long, long time. Chromium 6 was even the subject of the Hollywood blockbuster Aaron Brockovich, which was released in 2000. Question number three, how is Chromium 6 regulated? Not well. EPA's only regulation is for total chromium, and that makes absolutely no sense for a number of reasons. First, it treats the toxic and non-toxic forms of chromium the same. That's not how it should work. Second, the limit was set back in 1991 to address chromium levels that were so high that it was irritating people's skin. Let me say that in a slightly different way. The current EPA drinking water limit for this known carcinogen does not take into account the cancer risk from drinking the water. There's something wrong with that. Question number four, what is being done to protect people from Chromium 6? At some point this year, EPA is scheduled to release more data, which will be the basis for determining whether or not they will change the current regulatory limits. We're not holding our breath for any kind of meaningful action because a major factor in determining EPA's allowable limits is the cost to remediate the problem at the municipal level, which in the case of Chromium 6 is really, really expensive. Question number five, how do I remove Chromium 6 from my drinking water? If you want to remove Chromium 6 from your home's water, you need to use a water filter that is designed to do so. Boiling your water does not remove Chromium 6, nor do the most common pitchers and fridge filters. There are some filters that work very well. For example, Hydroviv's filters use a special type of filtration media that is extremely effective at removing Chromium 6 from water. Alternatively, there are a number of reverse osmosis systems out there that do a good job of removing Chromium 6, but then you have the downsides of reverse osmosis. Cost, complexity of installation, water waste, those types of things. If you have any questions about Chromium 6, feel free to email one of our water nerds at hello@hydroviv.com or visit hydroviv.com and use our live chat feature. Thanks so much for watching, and consider hitting the subscribe button if you want to learn more about your water and get breaking news about water quality crises as they unfold.